How's it going, guys? So I'm sure you can assume by now I have a brand new fancy printer that I'm super excited about. This means that I can print all my own photos and do all that in studio, so it's way cheaper, way easier. But we're going to talk about it a little bit more in depth right now, other than just a fancy new printer. But as you can see, the studio has changed a little bit. I painted it, I reorganized everything, I've got way more desk space. Pretty much everything has changed from when you guys last saw it in the previous video. And yeah, so it's quite exciting. There's quite a bit different now. A lot more space to work and just do things and have a nice setup and all that. So back onto the printer now. This is the Canon PIXUMA Pro 100. And now this is kind of their mid-tier photo printing printer. The one below it is the PIXUMA 1. And then the one above it is the Pro 1000 something. I think it's just the Pro 1000, which is a super nice printer, but that one goes for about $1,700 Canadian, and I am nowhere near at that level yet. So the reason I bought this one is because it's meant for photo printing. It's got a super nice print head. It can do up to 13 by 19 prints. So the prints you can see on the wall behind me, those are 16 by 24s. And that's my favorite size of prints. I have to say that's by far my favorite size, just because it gives the most kind of detail to scale to every goodness ratio that comes with printing. And yeah, so that's my favorite size. This printer isn't able to do that, but it's able to do the size down from there, which is 12 by 18. So which again, is a good size. It's quite a bit bigger than 8.5 by 11s, which is all I've been able really to do in studio for the past few, well, since I started photography. Kind of the things that really made me buy my own high quality printer was, for one, price. I've been watching this exact printer for months now. I've been saying, okay, if this printer goes on sale, I'm gonna buy it. And lo and behold, it was literally $200 off for the week. So the week that I'm recording this in, it's still $300. But that was just like, okay, I can't not buy this printer right now. So when I actually started doing the math about it, basically it worked out, the company in Toronto that I was buying prints from, for 12 by 18, it costs around 23, 24 bucks. And depending on how much you spend, shipping might be free, maybe not. So it was really just, every time I wanted to buy prints, I had to spend over the certain limit. With this printer, basically it comes out to around $7 to $8, depending on the quality and type of paper I use with it. So that is a super big savings. So as you guys can probably tell, I'm really like happy and bubbly right now because I'm just so excited about this whole printer thing. Basically, the whole reason I like printing is because it takes that full kind of circle of photography. You go out, you take the picture, you come back, you edit the picture, and then finally you print it off and get to see it like physically in front of you. It's such a cool thing in my opinion to see something you've kind of worked on and developed, and it's taken days, months, however long you've spent on working on something, just come into that physical realm. So that box you guys saw me opening in that B-roll segment is a Moab sample box, and it comes with a ton of different paper. I've got four prints in front of me right now of papers that I've been thinking about using so far. So our first one here is an image you guys may have seen, and this is on I got the tag upside down here, Entrada Reg Natural. So it's a fully cotton paper, but this is the one we just did, and this is more on a display type paper. So this paper, I do like it. If I ever make like a printed portfolio or anything like that, I would definitely be using this paper, because just the gloss and everything just looks so pretty. So this is a metallic paper, and it's a little bit warped because I don't know why it's so warped, but it's, yeah. So, and it's, you can see it's shiny because it's got a metallic finish on the front. So yeah, so I really want to try using this paper on like automotive or industrial stuff, or maybe some like cityscapes or something just really cool. So I'm thinking about going to like downtown Calgary and getting like a really cool like skyscraper shot that's all metallic, and then the metal would show through the paper because it would basically, and yeah, so that's my plan for that. I'm gonna try that out sometime soon. And it's a really nice paper. It's just not, it doesn't really work for landscapes and stuff. So the final print I've got here is probably the paper I'm gonna be going with. And this is, it's the same kind of metallic paper. Let me get, see if I can get it up here. But it's pearl. It's just gorgeous. And I've got this print, I've got this same print done by the company in Toronto that I was using previously. And it looks good. It looks very good, but it's on matte paper. And an image like this, again, it doesn't carry the same value to me on matte paper. But if I want like a stunning print, I want people to like look at it and be like, wow, that is amazing. I always want it done on this like high gloss, or especially this metallic paper, because it carries just so much more detail and impact, because it almost looks more true to life. like when I the matte picture kind of flattens everything together and doesn't give you as good of depth to it, whereas this like the high gloss or the metallic paper just gives you that like 3D depth, and you get that sheen as you move it, and it's just absolutely amazing. So guys, I forgot to mention, none of this is sponsored. I'm not sponsored by Canon or Moab. None of this stuff got sent to me for free for any kind of review or anything. So I hope you guys found this video at least somewhat interesting. I'm still super giddy about it. I got the printer yesterday and I've been kind of shooting this video and working with prints for the past day and a half. So I'm like a small child in a candy store right now. I just want to keep printing and printing and printing and hanging and sticking prints all over my walls. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. As always guys, feel free to leave a like because your support is always appreciated, and I will see you guys in the next video.